Exams may not be held until late summer or autumn, as the government believes it's unlikely that COVID-19 restrictions will be lifted in time for the beginning of June. It's a very uncertain time for students preparing to study for their Leaving Cert and Junior Cert. I'm joined on the line by someone who knows that feeling all too well. Conor Smith is a Leaving Cert student from Cavan. Conor, good morning.
Good morning, Pat. How are you?
I'm very well. Now, how have you been getting on? I mean, have you been doing the work that you should have been doing, where everything normal? Are you doing that at home?
Well, I suppose, Pat, yes, I am. I'm continuing on for the most part with my work, as a lot of students in the country are trying to do. I'm very lucky. I have a lovely uninterrupted space to study in. I'm blessed with a decent Wi-Fi connection. I don't have as many barriers as some of the students around the country may face. So I'm trying my best, as everyone else is, but it certainly is uncertain times.
Now, where you finished your coursework, had your teachers got through the whole Leaving Cert curriculum before the lockdown?
Yes, my teachers were very good. They had the majority of the courses finished, but I know for other schools across the country, that might not necessarily be the case. I'm blessed that teachers are sending resources and notes on to me digitally that I can take a look at and work away on my own. But it's certainly very different to the traditional classroom experience, and having to start from scratch on topics that you don't really know, it is difficult. Sure, if we could do that ourselves, we'll be bothered going to school at all. It's a very difficult position we're in, but we're getting there.
Now, what was your reaction to the decision on the orals?
My reaction, for definitely Irish, I was struggling with the trap picture, so it came as a relief to me, as for some students across the country. But for another subject like French, where I was very prepared and going into the exam confident, it kind of was a kick in the teeth, because I put so much work into it, and it's a perspective that you're seeing a lot around the country. People, expressing outrage that these exams didn't go ahead, even when they've put so much effort into them. Same with music.
Yeah, you feel it's unfair that you might have excelled in French, some other people might have excelled in music, and everybody gets the same grade. Just the practical solution. You know, the way they're giving all of those who are unemployed, whether they earned €100 a week or €500 a week, the Department of Social Protection is giving everyone €350 as a pragmatic decision. That's probably the reason they did that.
Yeah. Yeah, you're absolutely right. If you put everyone on a level pegging, one of the things that has emerged from this is the prospect of college points. If the standard is the same across the board and people have been given a leg up, whereby it's harder to distinguish those top-tier students, you'll see exams being marked harder, but for colleges, they're going to have to make it, from a lot of people are saying this, that they're going to have to make it easier to distinguish who deserves these college places and who doesn't, if we're all kind of on the same boat.
You've been looking at how other countries have been coping with this end of school exam situation. What have you found?
Well, Pat, across the world, countries have taken steps such as Norway, the UK and France, as we've seen, to provide clarity in these very uncertain times, with the French cancelling the BAC. And of course, they were already on the way from transitioning to a more predicted grade exam, assessment-based, classroom-based assessment model, and Norway as well, where the written exam only accounts for a very small percentage of their overall grade. And the UK, like we've seen, cancelling their GCSEs. So I think the main thing there is that one way or another, they've taken a decision. And that seems to be the main cause for outcry here in Ireland, the lack of clarity and ambiguity surrounding this. And to say that by hook or by crook, the Leaving Cert will continue, I think was very foolhardy when in a global pandemic, no one has any idea what's coming down the line. I suppose to save it by this time during the summer, that we'd be in a place to sit an exam is an incredible risk to take.
It's fair to say, though, that opinion is divided. That survey that was done, which encompassed a lot of students, self-selecting, admittedly, but just under half wanted the exams to go ahead in June, but the rest wanted them rescheduled or else using the predicted grades system that you were talking about. So, as I say, opinion divided.
Yeah, very much so divided. It's very hard to tell. That survey that you're talking about was done by the Irish Second Level Students Union. And it was an online survey conducted over 28,000 students. And what it found was that of the options provided of cancelling the Leaving Cert and going with predicted grades or postponing it to later in the summer they said that 49% of those people were in favour of predicted grades. And what you saw was 45% of the other options coming in at continuing with the Leaving Cert, but just postponing it, which is very difficult to say. I mean, if they postpone the Leaving Cert, I can see that as only being further demoralising the students.
Mm. Now, Conor, you're leaving school one way or the other, so you don't have to really pay that much attention to your teachers. So, would you be confident in the predicted grades they would give you?
Well, I suppose, like everybody else, opinion is very divided on this. And I suppose I would be for predicted grades being probably the most feasible solution right now to prevent against the risk-taking of the health risk that would be sitting physically exams. But I think that with the best will in the world, there could be an opportunity for bias to creep in with teachers. It certainly could appear, and not intentionally, but when you're on a very personal level with students, you know, you know that Susie's looking for this for her course, and you want to try as much so and accommodate them, which is why exam papers are corrected, you know, with just exam numbers. We don't know who they are. So there's an objectivity there. It maintains fairness, but with predicted grades, you could see bias popping in. But also, the maintaining fairness there is a very important point. And I know Dr. Anya O'Hanlon, Anya Hyland on RTE News has said that, you know, Ireland isn't very suited to this. But I think that it would only serve to disadvantage the already disadvantaged, is what she said. It's certainly
so you might process. What you're saying is, Conor, you know, someone might have a great day and do well in the Leaving Cert, but they had been a bit of a slouch during the year in terms of their grades. But I remember I myself was a crammer. I really put the big effort in the last couple of months before all my exams. The inter-cert as it was then, the junior cert now, the leaving cert, and all my college exams. I tended to put the real effort in. I enjoyed college throughout the year, and then put the real effort in the last couple of months. So if they were going on predicted grades for me, I might not have fared well. But, you know, you hope for a good day on the exam day, and that's where predicted grades would fall down.
Absolutely, absolutely. As well as that, I think that even though it is seen as untraditional, right now we're in very unprecedented times, and I think they do require untraditional thinking at this point. And, you know, everything as we know it has been disrupted by this COVID-19. Major events around the world have been cancelled, as we all know. So why is it that, you know, the Leaving Cert still has to go on? It's very strange. I suppose the main thing being that it puts it kind of into perspective, the kind of relevance of it in today's world. And that's one of my talking points, in that I think that this could be an opportunity for the department and the state exams commissions to look at the exams and maybe go as France are doing and continue their efforts to maybe evolve this system and bring in continuous assessment. It could be an opportunity to switch up the format.
Okay, to think outside the box, never waste a crisis, isn't that what they say? Lots of comments coming in. One is that because we live in such a litigious culture, middle-class parents who could afford to would take teachers to court when they didn't get the grades that the parents expected of their children. That's the predicted grade things. How will this be dealt with? Well, that's from Dan. I don't know, Dan, how that would be dealt with. There would probably be some sort of appeal process in advance of someone actually going to the High Court. But, you know, it will happen. I have no doubt about that. Anyway, Conor, look, thank you very much for talking to us. Conor Smith, a Leaving Cert student from Cavan, who seems to be coping quite well. But what he wants, as do most of his Leaving Cert colleagues, they want certainty. They want a decision. Lots of comments on this. I'll bring them to you after the break.